So if you're trying to decide between the K2 Fit 84 BOA and the Fit 80 BOA for $50, you'd be out of your mind not to upgrade to the Fit 84 BOA. This is a review of the K2 Fit 84 BOA. The Fit 84 BOA comes with 84 millimeter wheels, which are 80A hardness, which isn't great if you're gonna be using them on even asphalt pathways. They are not going to last very long. But the saving grace is they come with ILQ7 bearings, which is a massive upgrade over the Fit 80 BOA. And they do have the aluminum chassis, which is a big upgrade, in my opinion, in terms of long-term durability. Now, plastic chassis isn't the end of the world, but if you're buying a skate with a plastic chassis, it had better be extremely inexpensive. So the Fit 84 BOA, just like the Fit 80, the BOA lace system makes it a breeze to get on and off. It's designed exceptionally well. Super easy to put on, super easy to take off. Love that about them. For $250, they are giving the Macroblade 80 a run for their money. The Macroblade 80 will run you $200 to $250 as well. The Macroblade 80 has ABEX 7 bearings. ILQ 7 bearings are a huge upgrade. The only place that the Macroblade 80 beats the K2 Fit 84 BOA is in the wheel hardness department. And being that a new set of 84 millimeter wheels is going to run you at least $60 or $70 if you can even find a good pair, which they're becoming extremely rare. It's like these manufacturers don't even put replacement wheels on the market. You can only get the cheap ones from Amazon that fly apart, or alternatively, you know, $120 ones from some super expensive specialty company. It's a little frustrating. So for that reason, I would have a hard time justifying buying the Fit 84 BOA just because I know these wheels are not going to last and they're going to need replacing very soon. These are a great skate for cross training in terms of comfort, in terms of the longevity of the bearings, but the minimum hardness I look for in a inline skate wheel is at least 82A. Even with 82A hardness wheels, rotating them all the time. 500 kilometers down the road, you're looking at replacing them. So keep that in mind. And replacing them is going to be 50% of the value of this entire inline skate, which is crazy. So I'm not sure why they came stock with 80A hardness wheels, but they do. So if you're trying to decide between the K2 Fit 84 BOA and the Fit 80 BOA for $50, you'd be out of your mind not to upgrade to the Fit 84 BOA. Aluminum chassis, upgraded bearings, and that little bit of extra diameter in the wheel, probably you won't notice it, but it is there. And that extra diameter does help you go faster. It does dampen vibration more, and I believe it will extend the life of the wheel ever so slightly. As with all K2 models, keep in mind, they do fit small. You probably want a half size larger than what your US shoe size is. At least that's been my experience. The Rollerblade Macroblade size 12 fits right on. 20 kilometers, first skate, no problem. First skate in these, 10 kilometers in, feeling it, not super comfortable. Not as comfortable, but they will break in. K2s just have a longer break-in time, and they do fit small. So keep that in mind. Hope you found this review useful. If you're trying to choose between the plethora of 80 millimeter skates on the market, these ones are decent. Just hopefully you can find a pair that come with 82A or harder wheels. That would be ideal. Cheers.